everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Thank you for tuning in at home. Thank you all for coming today. We have a terrific studio audience, as you no doubt know by now, divided into three sections, blue, banana, and red, each one rooting for one of our celebrity couples. You're going to meet them now, and they're terrific. Let's get right to it. Shall we? On my left.
Yes, it is your left.
Dressed rather conservatively today, I might add.
No less than you, sir.
Winning money for the blue section, Mr. Bill Shatner and his wife, Marcia. Lafferty Shatner. Hi, Marcy. How are you?
Hi, Bert. Just great. Thank you.
You look lovely, too, as always. And I say, too, because Bill looks like his horse will come in any moment.
Oh, yes.
I got the horse.
I got my wife. She came in.
Don't let me pick on you now. That's terrific.
That's a horse of another color.
You said it. Yeah. And speaking of another color, the banana section winning money for them today is Mr. George Hamilton and his wife, Alana.
Yes.
Banana split.
That's not it. Alana, you look beautiful and lovely, and no doubt you know
Thank
that George
you, Bert.
Has an ice cream shirt on.
Yes,
either
I
that
just...
or he made a mess of it at Baskin-Robbins. Look at that.
You don't like my shirt.
That's terrific.
I think that's what your section said, split.
Look at his Roy Rogers outfit.
That familiar voice you heard is the mentor for the red section today. Let's welcome him, shall we? Mr. Scooy Mitchell and his lovely wife, Claire. We have three beautiful ladies. Claire, you round out our trio. How are you, love?
Thank you, I'm fine.
A friend of yours is raising his hand to be recognized. I recognize
a friend of mine?
The delegate from the pimento section.
Yes, sir. Sounded like it is, Trigger.
You did say Trigger. No, when you said Bill Shatner was waiting for his horse to come in, it just reminded me of an old joke that I used to do where I said, I had an old maid aunt.
Yes, yes. Don't let me give you a bad time.
Who waited so long for a ship to come in, her dock collapsed.
Okay. What happens is they kill your rhythm there. They just knock it right out.
Yeah. But he's got natural rhythm.
Yeah, right.
What does it mean when they're getting up and coming toward you?
No. It means
they want to
start winning
now.
Some money.
No.
But speaking of sartorial splendor, one of the three gentlemen today has a hole in his pants. We'll get to it. You know, I'd never pick on anything like that. But I just thought we'll get to that later, all right? I'm not... Three faces up
that's
there.
That's the question you ask the audience for the big prize.
Yeah, that's right. The big one. Money
Which
today.
Guy has a hole in his
All
pants?
Right, girls, this question is for you. It's worth $150, and here it is. Ladies.
Not me.
And I don't have to look.
No, right. Here comes. Now, wait a minute.
Hey, you got a hole in your pants.
Ladies, if a friend of your husband made advances to you and then realized his folly and apologized, would you tell your husband about it? Let me ask you again as soon as everything settles down here. If a friend of your husband's made advances to you and then realized his folly, whatever that means, and apologized, would you tell your husband about it? Think it over, ladies, and they are. And come back and tell us your answers in just a second.
Are you talking about cash?
You gotta give him credit.
Yeah, you gotta give him credit, but I wouldn't give him credit.
Well, don't give him cash.
No, but don't give him cash.
Because he's liable to make an advance.
It could say, if a friend of your husband, I think, made a pass, would be probably more in understandable English for you, George.
At the crap table.
No. Just, if the husband, never mind, you understand what I mean. Bill, what's Marcy gonna say?
Marcy is going to say that we talk as much about everything as we can. So I think ultimately the story would come out. Then I'd pop the guy. He'd pop me. I'd need plastic surgery, and she'd remarry.
Take out your little that little gun you used to have, and go Zappo.
Oh, Zappo! Yeah, on stun, right?
Okay, you're gonna say
she'd ultimately tell me. I don't know when.
All right, let's bring her on and find out. Marcy. We know that the situation is highly hypothetical, as they say. But would you tell Bill about it, do you think?
Oh, these are so hard. The first time, my answer would be no.
How about the second time?
Yes.
The first time you said no, and that's wrong. That's not what Bill said. He said he thought you would.
Yeah, no, I don't think I would.
Gee, am I glad to hear that. Because I tell you, I'm not going to do it again. It's the second time he's going to get me. I'm sorry, no share of the pot.
And I turn it off stunned and put it on whatever.
Put it on destroy, yes. All right, George, how about Alana?
No, Alana's pretty secretive, and she didn't want to. She doesn't really like to get. Are you there?
Yes, I dropped my card. I'm sorry.
I thought maybe if this is the big one. I'm going. And I don't think she would tell me. I don't think she would tell me. I think, you know, she'd admit it if I got her, you know, caught her.
What he wants to know is, what are you laughing at, Scooy?
I ain't gonna do it again either.
I'm not gonna touch it anymore. I'm just gonna say, no, she wouldn't tell me, and we'll move right on to
the king here. Okay. Now, never mind, Scooy. I know what you got in your mind. I know
tell
the line
Dale
you're playing
about
with
it.
There. Let's bring on Alana. Alana, would you tell George about this friend, or would you not?
I wouldn't.
That's right. That's what he said. I know it, Alana. We're having a wonderful time out here with this question, Alana, in case you can't tell.
I can imagine.
Oh, yes. It's going very well. You have a share of the pot, love. How about Claire Scooy? What's she going to say about that? Would she tell you about this fella, this friend who...
I think a lot of it would have to do with who it was.
Yes.
Now, she has spoken any number of times about you, Bert. And I've been cool. Mm-hmm. You know?
I'm remaining very cool now, but my heart is going...
No, I don't... My wife is a grown woman, and my wife can... pretty much handle her own affairs. That's a poor choice of words.
Yes,
right?
You said it. I didn't.
No, I don't think she would.
You don't think she'd tell you?
No.
You'll say no. Let's bring on Claire. Claire, what would you do now in that situation? Would you tell Scooy about it or would you not?
No, I wouldn't tell him.
You're right. That's what he said. Well done, Rev. That means Claire and Scooy, Alana and George, split the opening pot. There it is on the board. We'll come back and find out who's going to split all the rest of them in just a moment. Come on back with us. See you in a minute. Coming up, it's for you, ladies. It's worth $150, and here it is. Girls, you're at someone's home for the first time at a party. You make a trip to the powder room upstairs. Now tell the truth. After leaving the powder room, would you take a few minutes to do a little upstairs snooping? Don't say anything now. You're at someone's home for the first time at a party. You make a trip to the powder room upstairs. Now tell us the truth. After leaving the powder room, would you take a few minutes to do a little upstairs snooping? Think it over, ladies. We'll come back for your answer in just a moment. Okay, George, we're going to start with you this time. What do you think? Would Alana be... curious yellow, you should pardon the pun, since we're in the yellow section.
Oh, when I first met Alana, she was dressed in black working with Murph the Surf. But I would say that that's a little inside joke, you bet.
I didn't get it.
We're on a roll. Moving right along here.
We're on a roll.
I would say that, no, Alana's she respects privacy tremendously, hers and yours. Not yours, but anyone's.
Oh, I thought you were going to say she doesn't have to respect mine at all. It's all
but
right.
I would say no, that she would definitely not.
She wouldn't do it.
No. She's very good. That's one of the reasons I married her.
Oh, really? Doesn't snoop around a lot, huh?
No, she's really good.
Okay. Let's bring her on and find out. Alana, what are you going to do now? You've just come out of the powder room. There are all those intriguing doorways. Would you go and do a little snooping or would you not?
I don't think I would, Bert, because I wouldn't like anyone to do it in my house.
You're absolutely right. That's what George said. He said you respect the privacy of others, me included, and it was very nice of him to say that. You have a share of the pot. Thank you. Scooy, how about Claire?
My wife is paradoxical.
What does that mean?
I've been waiting all week to use it, though.
That's what is known as stalling for an answer there. You're thinking it over.
Paradox.
You can take something for it.
Oh, it's like,
Didn't you tell that story where the paradox fell while she was waiting?
No, paradox. It's like a dentist and a surgeon, a paradox.
No, I see. I thought she was waiting for a ship to come in and
trying to get out of it, Ira.
No, I had a paradox.
Oh, boy. I think I worked in this club once, many years ago. Long time ago.
Gee, you know, I really don't know. I really don't know. So I'll pass the rest of my time to,
That's not this, what is this, the Senate Judiciary Committee?
I yield to the gentleman on the right.
You can't yield your time here, sir. We need an answer from you.
I'm just going to take a shot in the dark.
Well, I'm doing all the lines, eh?
I'm going to say yes.
You're going to say yes.
Hold it.
Okay, Scooy, your answer is yes. All righty.
Hold it, Bert.
You know what that is.
No, please. Please, I don't want to make a race issue out of it.
Yes.
You're going to have the courage of your convictions taste tested by these people?
Say right. Paradox, George.
It's easy for you to say, right. George.
Yeah. You don't think she would? Well, it's your money, folks. I get paid whether you win or lose. Right? No.
You say...
How many say no?
Oh, boy. What have we decided on here, gang?
How many say yes?
The red section really predominantly says no. She won't look around. Let's bring her on and find out. Shh, don't say anything now. We don't want to give it away to you, do we, Claire?
Certainly not.
Claire, what are you going to do? You come out of the powder room. You're upstairs. First time you've been in this house. You going to take a look around or not?
No, I'm not going to look around.
You're right. That's what he said. In fact, the red section picked that one for you, dear. They said no. And he went with them. And you're absolutely right. Okay, smarties. Bill.
Thank you, Bert.
How about Marcy? What's she going to say? What would she do?
Well, the definition of the word snoop. I don't mean lifting up. Marcy's curious. She might look around a little. I mean, look at the pictures and then decide not to.
You changed your answer because they were advancing upon us, huh? When the blue section gets angry, you don't want to fool with them, I'll tell you.
Series 4, Marcy wouldn't touch a thing. No, she wouldn't.
Nothing. No. Nothing. Okay, the answer is no. Let's bring on Marcy. Shh. Now, don't say anything. Shh. We're having the best time, Marcy.
Yes, I bet.
Tell us, Marcy, what would you do? You're upstairs in that house now. You've never been there before.
Just a minute. Let's call it having an inquisitive mind and say yes.
I'm sorry. That's not what he said. You had a 50-50 chance there, Marcy, and you blew it.
Yeah.
I'm terribly sorry. That means Alana and George and Claire and Scooy got it right. They split the pot at halftime. We'll change places, fellas. Go on out here, ladies. While we're changing places, we'll break away for this message for you, and then we're coming right back. Come on back with us. See you in a minute. After halftime, I have the ladies with me. The fellas are in the back. Guys, you know the score, by the way?
No, what's the score?
You don't want to know, Bill.
Hey. Losing.
Bill, you have El Zippo at this point. Zero, yes. I'm sorry.
Bert.
Yes.
But, you know, I've been thrown by the fact that I keep hearing in the corridors, Convy is coming. Convy is coming. What do they mean?
I don't know. What do they mean?
Does that mean you're going on the Johnny Carson show?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's nice of you to say. Tonight, if you happen to be around, thank you, Bill. I thought you'd
explain it.
Yeah, I'm going to explain that, Bill. You're terrific, you know. Tonight on the Johnny Carson show, I'm going to host it, and if you happen to watch my guests...
That's what they mean.
Who are your guests?
Bert Reynolds and Carol Burnett and some more surprises. Please look if you can, okay? Thank you, Bill. Okay, here we go, gang. Moving right along with a $150 question. Men, you and your wife have been called for jury duty. The defense attorney questions you to see which of you would be more sympathetic to his client, who happens to be a little old man who is accused of flashing. That is exposing himself in public. Which of you do you think the defense attorney would pick to be on the jury? Let me rephrase that for you.
It's very complicated.
You and your wife have been called for jury duty. The defense attorney questions you to see which of you would be more sympathetic to his client. His client happens to be a little old man who is accused of flashing, that is, exposing himself in public. Which of you do you think the defense attorney would pick to be on this jury? For the defense, that is. Think about it, fellas. We'll come back for your answers in a moment. Well, isn't that silly? Claire, we're going to start with you this time.
Why'd you do that? Give me enough time to think about it.
What do you think Scooy's going to say? Which one of you would be more likely to be picked by the defense attorney to be on this man's side? You'd be on the jury.
Oh, to be on this man's side.
Well, you'd be to be more sympathetic to this little old fellow who's been going around. You know.
I'm just going to give you the answer. I'm not even going to qualify on
All right.
This.
Who's it going to be?
I think Scooy would say himself.
He'll say him.
Yeah.
He would be the most likely candidate for jury duty, then be more sympathetic to the fellow. Okay, let's bring him
in. In a case like this, yes.
Shh. Let's bring on Scooy. Scooy, which one of you would be more sympathetic to this poor fellow, do you think? And be picked by the defense attorney. That's the clue, of course. You might both be sympathetic, but who would the defense attorney go for?
Boy.
That's not the answer.
No. Me.
That's the answer. You're right. Tough question, but you are right, sir. Okay, Marcy, what's Bill gonna say?
I just don't know, but I think Well, we'd both be sympathetic, but he'll probably think I'm more sympathetic in general, so he probably will say me.
He'll say the defense attorney would pick you.
He goofed a question before, though, because you scared him, so I have to go with my instinct.
Yes, and don't scare him. Now, be nice. Okay.
Now you can stone me if I'm... No.
Well, yeah. You can't go any lower anyway, Marcy. What the heck? You're gonna say... I still am. You say.
I think they would pick me.
The defense, if you don't fall off your chair. The defense attorney will pick you for the jury. Let's bring on Bill and find out. Shh, shh, shh. Bill, now who is the defense attorney going to pick? You or Marcy to be on the jury?
Well, if it had been a little old lady, he would have picked me. But since it's a little old man, he'd pick Marcy.
You are right, sir. Very well done.
But you understand.
That's right.
What is that?
You understand. It's because Marcy's filled with the milk of human kindness.
Yes. We understand that, sir, and we thank you for your answer. And you also
homogenized
have
and skimmed.
Of that pot, yes. Alana, how about George? Between you and George, who would the defense attorney pick?
I think he'd pick George because I think George will say he's going to pick George.
Why?
Well, you never know. George may get old one of these days, and he may turn to flesh. Sympathetic with that poor little old man.
Okay. Let's bring on George. Don't say anything now. Don't give it away. George. Oh, hello there.
Oh, hi.
Young fellow. Listen, George. Which one of you do you think that defense attorney would pick as being more sympathetic to the old fellow?
I definitely say that me.
He says, taking off his clothes and closing doors. You're all right, gang. We split the pot three ways. Very well done. Okay, there it is, and we'll come back in just a moment to find out who's going to win this one. It's getting wild here. Come back with us, won't you? $300, and if you've noticed, gang, Bill, you have $50, and George, you and Scooy are tied at $200 apiece, so anybody can still win, really. Here we go. Men, this question is worth $300. Which one of you enjoys being alone more often, you or your wife? Which one of you enjoys being alone more often, you or your wife? Think about that, gentlemen. We'll come back for your answers in a moment. There they go. We'll start with you, Marcy. It's
me.
You.
Yeah.
You like to get off by yourself and be quiet, more than Bill. He's social
if
and outgoing.
If he says him, I'm going to be... it's me,
If he says him, let him stay alone for a while.
He doesn't like to be alone.
Okay.
He likes us to be alone together, but being alone separately, me.
Okay, you say you, let's bring on and see what he says. Bill, between you and Marcy, who enjoys being alone more?
I'd say Marcy.
That's what she said, and you're right, sir. You have a share of the pot. You have a share of the big one, in fact. Thank you, Bill. Alana, between you and George. Who enjoys being alone more?
Well, we were just talking about that on the way down here because we have about 11 people in our house right now, and I love to have people around, and he doesn't, so it's George.
George is the one.
Yeah.
Let's bring him on and find out. George, between you and Alana, who enjoys being alone more?
I do.
That's right. What you said. Okay, you have a share of the pot too, George. Claire, you're going to make it three ways here? You're going to keep the tie going?
I sure hope so. We make it three ways. I do.
You enjoy being alone more.
He's much more social than I am. Oh. I enjoy being alone more so.
Okay, let's bring on Scooy and find out. Here we go. Scooy, between you and Claire, who enjoys being alone more?
Claire.
You're right. That's what you said. You're smarties. You're all right. We split that pot three ways down the middle. There it is. Wow, look at that. Still a tie on the banana and the red section. Still have a tie of $300. Time is up. We still have a tie. It ends that way. Alana and George, Clarence Scooy, end in a tie. We'll come back in a moment to find out how much they have won after this message for you. Come back. See you in a minute. Section, the red section, $300 a piece. We add $1,000. They will divide $1,600. Scooy is going off to get his pants fixed now. In case you're wondering, we'll see you next time. Hi, Scooy. If you have time tonight, please watch. Bert Reynolds and Carol Burnett. Goodbye, everybody. See you later.
Gossip Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning in to Tattletales. Welcome. Welcome to all of you, too. Are you ready to go? I have a good feeling about today. I think we're going to have a good time because I know these guys up here are super, and I think you're going to enjoy it, too. On my left, star of Adam 12, winning money for the blue section today, Mr. Marty Milner and his wife, Judy.
Ready to go. Sounded like you were introducing two fighters. I like that.
Yes, coming out of this corner. Well, right. That's really kind of what it is here, isn't it?
Okay, the chips are done.
The gloves are off now, gang. This is it. Winning money for the...